what's going on, guys? LethalFlux here, and sorry I haven't uploaded in a month. It's just work's been crazy, and I don't know. Like I said, I don't like uploading whenever I don't want to because I feel like my quality kind of suffers. So I'm bringing you guys an updated deck profile. This is post new challengers, so it has El Shaddoll Fusion, Shekinaga, and Grista, and quite a few things have changed. So we're gonna go through the deck profile real quick. I've been doing actually okay with it, pretty good actually. So yeah, let's get to it. Here's the monsters. Two Shaddoll Falco. Pretty standard. I don't know. Some people cut it to one. I like two still. Two Skamata sends everything. Really good. Next one's debatable. I only play two Shaddoll Beast. For some reason, I don't like three. When I've tried playing three, and three just it always swarms my hand. I don't really like it.
Okay.
The only one that I would play three of is Shaddoll Dragon, but I cut it to two. Just cause, but I really liked it when it was at three. I might put it back to three. I think it's the best one for some reason.
I feel like three dragon this format would be okay.
I really like
Clefortz running around.
This card is really good. Clefortz, it's good against the mirror match because you can chain the Sinister Shadow games and just bounce in the mirror match. It's really good. And then the one Hedgehog. A lot of people cut this to one. I might cut it to two because El Shaddoll Fusion is in here. Or I might put it to two because El Shaddoll Fusion is in here. But
okay.
For now, I still like one even though we have El Shaddoll Fusion. This is kind of a little engine right here. I still run three Mathematicians. This card's amazing, especially with Shekinaga out. It's an Earth, so you can use it for materials for Shekinaga, and you get to draw one. Amazing. I still play kind of a little Chaos engine. We got two white, two black.
Two
self-explanatory.
Black.
Two white, one black, sorry.
Here we go.
Self-explanatory, hasn't changed. I get to play Glow Bulb, yay. It's a tuner, it's really good. Shekinaga, you can pitch it with Mathematician or from the deck using El Shaddoll Fusion. So yeah, I really like Glow Bulb. One Eclipse Wyvern for the Dark Arm Dragon. And the two boss monsters, the Dark Arm Dragon and the BLS. I can usually summon these pretty consistently. I usually sat out the Eclipse Wyvern and the Dark Arm Dragon game two just because.
Yeah.
So that's it for the monsters. I don't know how many monsters that is, but it's a lot. I think it was like 20, something like that. Moving on to the spell cards, we got three Shaddoll Fusion. That hasn't changed. Some people have two and two, two Shaddoll Fusion, two El Shaddoll Fusion. I personally like three because this lets you fuse from the deck. It's really good. Two El Shaddoll Fusion. This card is really amazing. I honestly think it's the best card in the deck now.
Now think about if this card lets you fuse from the deck too.
That would be absolutely ridiculous. I'd play three. I'd play four.
Ridiculous.
Yeah, this card, I absolutely love this card because you can do it from your hand on the battle phase, or if they try to effect Veiler, your Falco, you can just chain this. You still get Falco's effect or Beast's effect because it's off the field and effect Veiler doesn't know where it's at. So El Shaddoll Fusion is just amazing. For the one-ofs, one Foolish, one Super Polymerization, still really good. One Soul Charge, I might cut that for a Mind Control, because I play Mind Control. And one Regeki. Rogue matchups, it's a Locals deck for now, but if I were playing at Regionals, I'd probably cut this and keep the Soul Charge for a Mind Control. Let's get on to the traps. My last deck profile, I didn't run three Sinister Shadow games. Now I am. Three Sinister Shadow games. It's really good, like I said. You can chain it and to things, usually to MST. So if people buy an MST, chaining this is really good because you get the effects of everything.
And, now, has your win rate gone up since getting
it
three?
It actually has, yeah. Because chaining this and flipping a Skomata or a Dragon to bounce or destroy something is really, really good. It's just, especially a Dragon in the mirror match because you bounce things with a Dragon. It's amazing. Two Trap Stun. I personally really like Trap Stun. Fire Lake. I mean, I care about Fire Lake to an extent. I don't care if they Fire Lake my monster. I do care if they Fire Lake my back row. Because Fire Lake's annoying. I just don't like Fire Lake, so that's for Trap Stun. And Skill Draining Clefords and Shadow Imprisoning Mirrors or whatever. Two Breakthrough Skill. I might cut this. The only reason I'm running it right now is because there's things like Fusions and Centellar Knights on my Locals. I don't know what I would replace it with. I'd probably replace it with two Vanity's Emptiness, because this build's only running one, but yeah. Two Breakthrough Skill. It's also good in Mirror Match against Winda. And, yeah. Phoenix Wing Windblast. I think this card's really, really good. You can make your opponent dead draw and you can return the Shaddoll fusions in the mirror match so they don't get their effects. Card's just really solid. I think it's one of the best traps this format.
Phoenix Wing, Wind Blast, and Glow Bulb, guys.
Yeah, exactly. And you can discard the Wyvern, you can discard the Glow Bulb. You can also, if you have a Super Polymerization and you use Super Polymerization to get out of one of your fusions, you can discard, yeah, whatever. Not going to go into that. It's a long story. One Shaddoll Core. This card's really good now because of Grista. And you can get back. There's more targets to get back with it, because when it's sent from the deck to the graveyard by a card effect, you can get Elshaw Fusion or Shaddoll Fusion, and just five targets for it now. Also, like I said, Grista, really good. One Compulse and one Vanities. I like one Vanities right now, to be honest. I don't run Solemn Warning or Bottomless. I probably should run Bottomless, but Solemn Warning I'm fine without.
Can I afford a second of
it? Let's get into the extra deck. It's changed quite a bit. We're going two Construct. It's still really good. It's still really good. Because I don't want three. Two Winda. It's okay. It's not the best card in the extra deck at all. I think it's actually the worst out of the fusions, to be honest. Until the Wind one comes out, because that one sucks ass. But I really like it against things like Satellar Knights and stuff. But against like the strong top three right now, Burning Abyss, and it's okay against Burning Abyss, but
it'll just get Karma Cutted or Wing Blast.
Something will happen to it, because they can take advantage of all the cards that make you discard, like Wing Blast and
Karma. I can run over it with Dante. Like
exactly. Yeah. Shaginaga, this one's oh my god, this card's amazing. You can like sit on it, has 3,000 defense, or you can keep it in attack mode if you like. I think you all know what this does, but I'm going to explain it anyway. So you discard a Shaddoll card.
You don't have to pay cost, right, unless it goes through?
No, it's not a cost. It's a...
No, I'm saying that you have to discard one, right? That's only if it goes through?
Yeah, it's not a cost to discard one. So to negate the effect of a special summon monster, discard a Shaddoll card. It's really good. Once per turn. So that's Shaginaga. And then we have El Shaddoll Grista. This card's a Solemn Warning, but you activate it by doing the same thing as Shaginaga. Discard a Shaddoll card. Really good. I like it. It looks badass, too. Two Castell. I love Castell. Mainly this is for Cliff Forts, because you shuffle the equip spell, so they don't get to search off the equip spell. And other things. Really amazing. This is actually supposed to be a Yazzie, Evil of the Yang Zing, the level 7 big guy. I wouldn't play Diamond Direwolf. I play Yazzie, Evil of the Yang Zing over Diamond Direwolf. Sidon Arc, still a staple, still really good. Star Eater, because it's Shaddoll Core, I can make it now, and it's gigantic. It's amazing. Black Rose Dragon, Arcanine Magician for level 7s. I might cut this. I like it, but I might cut it. Or I would cut the Diamond Dire Wolf for an Armory Arm, because Armory Arm is amazing, and it helps you get over a Killer and a lot of other stuff. One Goyal Guardian for the 6, one Armadies. Self-explanatory. I'm going to skim through the side deck really quick, and then it'll be over. Two Maxis, two Effect Veilers. Those are the hand traps. One Granmal, Mirror Match, and that actually helped against Neteria Beast today. Two MST, two Spell Shattering. These should be Fairy Winds. Fairy Winds a lot better. Double Pulling the Rug for Satellars. Double Anti-Spell Fragrance. I like it. And two Light Imprisoning Mirrors for things like Constellars and Satellar Knights, because that's all over the place. So, yeah. Thank you so much, you guys, for watching. Sorry again that I haven't uploaded in a while. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much. Take it easy.